Talk about how to relax the quads after doing sleds. I know a lot of you guys at Byron Center did a lot of sleds today and your legs may be feeling sore. You're welcome. You're welcome on that one. So today what we're going to do is we're going to work on using the foam roller. So the first one we're going to do is how to roll the quads. We haven't really talked about it too much. It's been on the video in the back, but I'm going to teach you how to really use it and what to look for. Now, with the foam roller, you're going to start just above the knee. You're gonna have your elbows on the ground just like you do in a plank. Notice my other leg is slightly bent and to the side. Now from here, I'm gonna start just above the knee and go back all the way up to the hip and up and down, all right? So you just rock back and forth, rolling that leg. Now you can turn the foot inward, you can turn the foot outward. Each way, you're working on different muscles. We have four quadricep muscles. That's why I call it the quadricep, because there's four different muscles in there. And so you can work on getting and rotating that foot so you get multiple different sides of those muscles. Now, think 8 to 10 reps on each side, all right, each side of your legs, and then probably do 2 to 3 times you can do that. If you're feeling really, really sore, don't go too crazy with that. Don't try to put a lot too much pressure in it because that can make it inflamed. We don't want to do that. It's already inflamed. We just want to help reduce that soreness, help create more blood flow, and make sure that we can have that full range of motion when we exercise. Now, the next one, if you're feeling any quadricep tendon or quadricep tendon pain, this is a really good exercise for this. So put it in the same position, but now put it right just above the knee, not on the joint, just above the knee, and then you're gonna flex the knee and extend the knee. Now do 10 reps, then roll just a little bit higher, do another 10, and work your way through the leg. Now what you're doing is you're helping that muscle relax while you're going through the full range of motion. You're forcing it to put a little bit more outside pressure on it to make it elongate to the right position. Now, the last one is the greatest stretch alive. I love this one, all right? So this, you can go from feet a little bit, I'm gonna show you kind of like at an angle. So your feet are gonna be just on the outside of your hands are gonna be in. We've done this a lot in boot camp where you have your hands, or your knees on the ground, or you've lifted that knee and you've opened up at the top. Either way, it doesn't really matter. I like putting the knee down to the ground because what that does is it activates the hip flexor a little bit more and opens the hip. You get a little bit of hamstring in the front leg and you're just gonna hold, squeeze the glutes, think about contract 5 seconds, relax, try to push a little bit more, and then keep working through that. But make sure you do the same amount of time on each side. Now, we just want to make sure we're working on both sides evenly, and I hope you have a good rest of your day. You guys, if this helped, please comment below.